What's up guys, this is Bryce with Dust Runners Automotive Journal, and today we're going to talk about the Toyota 1UZ. The 1UZ is the first engine in the Toyota UZ family. Toyota designed this new 4-liter V8 to replace the outdated Toyota 5V. The cult following for the 1UZ-FE has grown a massive amount in the last few years. Just like the LS and Ford Modular engine families, the Toyota UZ engine family has been heavily modified and is well known amongst the tuner community. If you didn't already know, the 1UZ-FE was a pretty advanced engine at the time it came out. Very few V8s at the time were dual overhead cam with 32 valves and actually reliable. The 1UZ-FE is arguably the first ever reliable Japanese dual overhead cam V8 and is definitely one of the greatest. The cylinder block of the 1UZ-FE is made of cast aluminum and uses a 90-degree design. The cylinder heads are also made of cast aluminum. Like I mentioned before, it is a dual overhead camshaft engine with 32 valves and 4 valves per cylinder. Unfortunately, the 1UZ-FE does not have hydraulic lifters. Instead, it uses a shim over bucket design, so it periodically needs valve adjustments. Later versions of the 1UZ-FE received Toyota's VVTi system, which improved horsepower and fuel economy. The 1UZ came in a variety of Toyota vehicles, ranging from sports cars to luxury cars. Toyota equipped the 1UZ in the Lexus GS400, LS400, and SC400. The 1UZ was also equipped in the Toyota Aristo, Celsior, Crown, and Soar, none of which we got in the US. Like I mentioned before, the 1UZ has come in a couple different forms over the years. Engine changes such as the addition of VVTi increase horsepower and torque. It started at 256 horsepower and 260 foot-pounds. Then Toyota added higher compression pistons, which bumped power up to 261 horsepower and 269 foot-pounds. The addition of VVTi bumped power up to 290 horsepower and 300 foot-pounds of torque. The final version of the 1UZ received minor revisions, which increased power to 300 horsepower and 310 foot-pounds of torque. As you might be able to tell from these numbers, the VVTi system worked wonders on the 1UZ-FE. The VVTi system added 34 horsepower and 40 foot-pounds over the original version of the engine. Most notably, the VVTi system brought peak torque down by 400 RPM, making the car much more fun to drive around on the street. So you might be wondering how this engine can be tuned to make more horsepower than it did from the factory. Naturally aspirated builds can reach as high as 400 horsepower, sometimes more, but it's really expensive to build engines that way. The Terminator Cobra supercharger, or Eaton M90, is a common addition to the 1UZ-FE. With additional changes such as fuel injectors and an exhaust system, the 1UZ with the addition of an Eaton M90 can easily make 350 horsepower at 6 pounds of boost. Building the bottom end with a lower compression ratio pistons, the 1UZ can easily make in excess of 450 horsepower at 10 pounds of boost. Turbo kits are available for most cars that came equipped with the 1UZ, but they need a built bottom end to survive. Much like other great Toyota engines, such as the 1JZ and the 2JZ, the stock 1UZ block is good for pretty crazy amounts of horsepower. Nissan's VH45DE was the only real competitor to the 1UZ at the time. They both used dual overhead camshafts, they both had a displacement of less than 4.6 liters, they both came from Japan, and they were both designed for luxury cars. The VH45DE made an impressive 278 horsepower and 294 foot-pounds of torque, but that was less than the 1UZ made in its final versions. To be more specific, the 1UZ made 22 horsepower and 16 foot-pounds more than the VH45DE, while also being 0.5 liters smaller. So overall, Toyota knocked it out of the park with the 1UZ-FE. Not only is it powerful, but it's also really reliable. I had an SC400 equipped with the 1UZ, and I loved how that car felt, although that 1UZ ultimately ended up dying. Be sure to hit that thumbs up button, subscribe, and let us know what you think of the 1UZ in the comments down below. This is Bryce with Dust Runners Automotive Journal, signing off.